In this video, we will study about those tribes who lived by herding animals. Now, herding and rearing are the two jobs which were done by this group of people. And those who do herding and rearing are called as pastoralists. Now, they moved from one place to another place with their animals. And especially they moved from season to season. If they are living in a particular season at a particular place, and if the grass finishes or dries off, then they will move on to some other place where grass is available. So according to the availability of grass, they will take their animals from one place to another place. Now there are many types of tribals who do this herding and rearing of animals. So we will take example of three cases. One is Van Gujjars of Punjab Hills. Van Gujjar is the name of the tribe of Punjab Hills. So these Van Gujjars and Labadis of Andhra Pradesh, Labadi is one of the tribes of Andhra Pradesh. These two tribal groups are cattle herders. Cattle means especially cow, buffalo. These are for cattle. So they usually rear and herd cattle. So Labadis of Andhra Pradesh and Van Gujjars of Punjab Hill take or rear cattle. While the Gaddis is a tribe of Kullu area in Himachal Pradesh. So they usually rear the sheep. So that is why they are called as shepherds. While in Kashmir there is a tribal group who are called as Bakarwals. And they usually rear goats. So different animals are reared in different areas, and all of them are included in herding of animals. So this is one of the occupations carried out by the tribal people. Now, apart from herding animals, there is one more group of tribals who do settled cultivation. We have already studied about shifting cultivation. So in shifting cultivation, people used to move from one place to another place. But in settled cultivation, the peasants used to cultivate on the same land for years and years. While in shifting cultivation, they cultivate land and then leave it as fallow land for so many years, and then they go back to the other land. While here, they cultivate it year after year. Now in shifting cultivation, we have seen that they use only hoe or to dig the mud or to dig the soil. But here they are using plow, and they are more advanced than the shifting cultivators, and they got the rights over their land. So they authorized that this is our land and nobody else can take the land. So they said that they have the right over the land. Now there is a tribal group called Mundas in area called Chota Nagpur. So the Mundas of Chota Nagpur, they all belong to the same clan, that is same group. And all of them said that the whole area of Chota Nagpur area, that land belongs to these Mundas. And they said that their ancestors came and settled first in these areas, and it was they who started cultivation. So as their descendants, these Mundas have the right over the land. So they said that they regarded the members as they are the members, and they are the descendants of the original settlers. So these original settlers first came and cleared the land, and so they also have the right over that land. Now, out of this Munda tribe in Chota Nagpur plateau, when the whole clan claimed the land and they said they have the right over the land, so it was such a big group that some of them became chief of that clan and some of them became the followers of that clan. Now those chiefs who hold power, they now used to give the lands to their followers, and these peasants started cultivating the land, and the rich people or the owners or the powerful people did not do the cultivation, and they only rendered the land to the country races. So in this way, social division occurred among the tribal people also, and that too when shifting to a settled cultivation started, then this social division occurred. Some were chiefs, some were followers. Now these are the four ways in which tribal people used to earn their living. Now when the British came, they thought that those people who are doing shifting cultivation, or those who are doing herding or hunting and gathering, these people they considered as wild and savage. That means they considered these people as uncivilized, and they felt that those who are doing settled cultivation, like the Gonds and the Mundas, they are better than the other group. And so British saw hunters and gatherers and shifting cultivators as wild and savage, and they felt that these people are to be settled and they have to be civilized so that they can get revenue from these people, and they did not like those people who did shifting cultivation and hunting gathering, etc.